Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to share with you my 2 week weight symptoms day by day. So I will go through each day, DPO, days past ovulation, that I experienced symptoms. I will share those with you and hopefully you find this video helpful. I know when I was in my 2 week wait period, I binge watched all the 2 week weight symptoms videos out there. I experienced a lot of symptoms. So I will share those all with you. In case you're new, while I'm filming this, I'm actually 4 weeks pregnant and 3 days. Super early and so excited. This is baby number two. I have a two-year-old son named Hugo and we are so excited to be growing our family. So let's jump in to my 2 week weight symptoms. We'll start with one DPO. So again, DPO stands for days past ovulation, and I got a positive ovulation test on February 29th. That was the first time that I got a very positive ovulation test. On DPO March 1st, I felt very crampy. Now, of course, one DPO, you do not all of a sudden have a fully formed embryo implanted in your uterus, but these are just the symptoms that I experienced. I felt very crampy. I still felt a really high libido, and that's something that I have felt since I stopped breastfeeding my son. Since my period and cycle returned, I felt very in tune with my body. Like I knew every single cycle when I was ovulating. I just had these like really intense symptoms, and I made videos on that before. So one DPO, I still felt like my libido was really high from the day that I was ovulating, from the days surrounding it. I wrote ovulation cramps with a question mark, because I did feel some cramping. But I wasn't sure if that was still like residual ovulation cramps or not. Late night, really bad headache. So I had a really bad headache right before I went to bed. Two DPO, felt really crampy still. I had diarrhea in the morning, kind of gross. Stiff uterus at night. So it felt very stiff. And again, I have a very good connection with my body and it felt different. Like it didn't feel like how it normally feels. It felt actually, and this is gonna sound kind of gross, but it felt kind of full, like it was full of something, like there was stuff in it that hadn't been there before. Three DPO, I experienced diarrhea, that diarrhea feeling in the morning, but I had normal bowel movements. I had a little bit of congestion, I cried, cramps at night, and I had like little pangs, so like little, not like shooting pains, but like little pangs, little feelings, I'm guessing like in my uterus area. For DPO, I had a weird dream last night, but not too out of the normal, I wrote down, because I know that sometimes really early pregnancy symptoms for some women are like scary dreams. I was hungry at 7:20 in the morning, I wrote down, which is pretty unusual for me. I tend to be able to like go a few hours before eating in the morning. I'm hungry and tired, but I didn't sleep well last night. Runny nose at 1 p.m., bloated and feeling meh. So 5 DPO, I had very faint spotting at 9:30 a.m. And I mentioned this in my first pregnancy update video. I experienced spotting in this early pregnancy that I never experienced with my son, which was scary to me. On 5 DPO, that was the first time I saw the very, very faint spotting, and I thought that that meant that I was maybe implanting on 5 DPO. Now, I know that that's really early, and normally you implant from 7 to even like 11 or 12 DPO. Just depends on the body. I don't know. I did feel really energized that day. I had cramps at 5 p.m., out of breath, teaching dance. I'm a dance teacher. I just felt pregnant. I just did. 6 DPO, stressful travel day, felt nothing. So from 6 DPO to 11 DPO, we actually traveled to Arizona and visited my husband's parents. So it was a travel day. I didn't even have a moment to think about anything or like feel anything. 7 DPO, I dreamt I took a pregnancy test and it was positive. I had no real symptoms all day, maybe a little bit of nausea in the afternoon. I did have breast tenderness at night and I wrote breast growing question mark. So naturally I have really small boobs, and I definitely felt like my boobs were growing a lot. 8 DPO, no weird dreams, afternoon felt crampy, feel pregnant and so bloated last night is what I wrote down. ADPO, I just felt pregnant. That's like such a vague thing to say. You can't back that up with science at that point. Maybe if I had taken a pregnancy test, I would have seen a really, really faint line if I implanted really, really early, but there's no way to know. 9 DPO, I was very moody all day. I had creamy white CM. So the cervical mucus part of this whole 2 week wait period confused me a little bit because I could have sworn when I was pregnant with my son that I didn't have any CM, but I'm guessing I must have and just like remembered it wrong in my mind. So 9 DPO, I had creamy white CM, and I'll say like I'm 4 weeks and 3 days now and I still get some creamy white CM now. So 10 DPO, feel out of breath and tired in the morning. Uterus feels bloated at 9:45 a.m. 11 DPO, nothing. It was a travel day. And then when we got home, so that night, it was like really, really late at night, and I was going to change into my pajamas in the bathroom, and I saw a lot in my underwear, a lot of really dark, dark, dark brown spotting discharge, and that was really scary. I, again, like hadn't experienced anything like that with my first pregnancy, and I got really, really nervous, but it was so late at night. I was so tired. I didn't want to take a pregnancy at that point because my husband was like already, he was already in bed under the blankets. Like I woke him up to show him the spotting, but I figured I can wait till the morning. Like it wasn't getting any worse. It was just like, it was just what I saw in my underwear. So 12 DPO, I woke up and I still had a little bit of that like dark brown spotting. So I decided to take a pregnancy test, got my positive pregnancy test, and I'll show you guys, I have it here. I'll make a test progression line video so you could see, but this is the stick test. So that's 12 DPO right there, and you can see it's a pretty noticeable line. So I think if I would have tested at 10 DPO, I think I would have gotten a faint line. That's when I think, maybe it was 12 DPO that I got my first little line with Hugo. I can't quite remember, but that's like dark enough that I think if I would have tested 11 DPO or 12 DPO, I mean 10 DPO, I think I would have seen a line, but I was so excited. And then on 12 DPO, the spotting had stopped in the morning and all of the pregnancy symptoms hit me like a freight train. I'm actually feeling a little bit nauseous right now, I'll be okay. It hit me like a freight train. I don't know if I experienced this because I got the positive test or if like everything was just hitting me all at once, but I had sensitive nipples. My boobs like all of a sudden felt really full. I had to go to the bathroom a lot, frequent urination. I was really thirsty. I had a little bit of heartburn. I felt bloated and I wrote down all my symptoms kicked in. So again, I don't know if they all kicked in because I knew I was pregnant and I had had the confirmation with the test or what, but I wrote all those symptoms down. Then 13 DPO, slight bloating, worked out and felt good. So technically 14 DPO, the end of like the 2 week wait period, even though I knew I was pregnant, I had cramping in the AM. I continued with some of my symptoms until cycle day 20 and they were just, oh, 15 DPO, I did experience some spotting in the morning and I had like cramps, which again made me a little bit nervous, but I try not to think too like deep into it. The spotting had like was really, really small, and it wasn't even enough to show up in my underwear, which was good. And then since then, my boobs have just, I feel like they've grown a lot. They've become a lot more sensitive. I have been trying to eat and work out and stay as healthy as possible. I've had a little bit of acid reflux. I've been drinking a ton of water. I felt very thirsty. But besides that, everything has been coming and has been pretty mild so far. It's still really, really early, so I'm sure all of like the intense nausea and exhaustion and stuff will hit me in a few weeks. But guys, those are my 2 week wait symptoms. I hope you enjoyed this video. Again, to each his own, everyone is different. I know some women don't experience any symptoms during the 2 week wait and still get a positive test. So if you didn't experience any of these symptoms, don't get nervous. It is not an indication that you are not pregnant. You just, everyone's body is different. Don't forget to subscribe for more pregnancy videos. I'm so excited to be sharing this journey with you all. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and I will see you in my next one. Bye guys.